Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Brigitta. And in the video for today, I'm going to show you the beautiful swap that I received from my friend Nadezhda, the pink shop here on YouTube. Maybe you remember that we had a monthly challenge together last year. And each month, one of us would think of a project and we would make that for each other. And at the end of the year, we would switch all those projects out. Well, it took us a little bit longer. We switched it out a few weeks ago. And in this video, I'm going to show you what she made for me. She did far more than we agreed on. So it's a lot of things that I'm going to need to show you. And I'm not sure if I can put it all in one video. But we'll just begin and let us see how long it will take us. And the first thing I'm going to show you is a beautiful postman bag. Look how cute it is. This was a project, and I do think it was invented by Mummy and Me Crafts. I'm not 100% sure. We followed a tutorial and she made it in the beautiful Maggie Holmes style for me, as I did for her. And she used a beautiful yellow cardstock, as you can see in one of my favorite pages from the Gardener collection from Maggie Holmes. Look how cute she decorated the straps with this beautiful trim. And here she made a cluster with the chipboard piece and a gorgeous heart. I think she got those on AliExpress from a design team that she got. Guest design team. How cute is this? It's such a nice project to make. Not so difficult and really sweet. And on the inside you have, she used file folder cards to make a room to house some embellishments. And I'm going to show that to you, of course, as well. So I'm going to take them out. And I will put everything back in later. And I have to make room at the side to put everything. Look how cute. She made beautiful border embellishments here. Can you see it? With pleated paper. Some extra ribbon on top and chipboards, and she made clusters on the chipboard. These are so cute. You can use this on a page, of course, but these are as well beautiful to put on a bag topper. I love it, but for now I am going to hoard them, of course. These are again beautiful strips. Love this. So cute. Beautiful glasses. Really adorable. And here she made some coin or circle embellishments. Cute little bee. Can you see it? How cute. It's a resin bee. Really sweet. And here she has some different ones. So that was one of our projects. Then I received this. And I don't think this was one of our projects. I didn't make this. So this was something extra. I'm sorry for the crinkling. I have a lot of them still in the bags. Look how cute it is. She made a book album, I think I can call it. I love this embossed paper that she used on top. She had a lot of Valentine projects made this year. And that's what she also added to our agreed on projects. And look how cute it is. She used a cake stand with mini donuts. On top there is, as you can see, acetate, so it is the cloche of the cake stand, and it closes with ribbon made from chipboards, really sturdy. And when you open it, she has some beautiful handmade rosettes that she did for me. And I think she knows that I, well, hate is a big word, but I do not like making rosettes. I always try to let my husband make them if I am in need of them. And she made a few for me. So thank you, Nadezhda. I love that. You already did the work for me. And I can close it like this. So I will do that after the video, because I have so much to show you. Well, it's not normal. This is another cute item that she gifted. Also not one of our projects, I think. I have to see. I didn't take it out yet. How it's... Most of the items I already took a look at, because you know me, I am far too curious. I do think I have to cut this to open it. I'll put on my reading glasses so I don't cut into the paper. because I don't want that, of course. It's too cute. We do swaps for a long time now and we know what we like from each other. So yeah. To the side and look how cute. She made an acetate bag. Do you see it? How sweet this is. I love it. I never made an acetate one. And she decorated it really cute with the rosettes and some stickers. I think she used a Create Paper Collection that we both have digitally. I'm not sure how it's called anymore. I didn't do any Valentine crafting. Well, hardly any Valentine crafting this year. But look how cute. And she added some chocolate eggs for me so I can snack from. So they will keep on my desk, of course. Then the next item I did myself as well. And that's a beautiful embellishment box. She used the same ice cream box as I used that we bought at our local Action store. She decorated it really quickly, really cute with this paper. And she used, can you see it? Really tiny sequins as the sprinkles and a beautiful butterfly. Let's open what's on the inside. And again, I'm not going to take every small little tiny thing out because then it will be too long. But she filled it with a lot of handmade embellishments. So I really loved. She made some paper tassels for me. That's also a thing I don't like to make. Look, she made cute little charms with my, how do you call that in English? Well, with the first letter of my name on it, my initial. How cute. Oh, so sweet. She did several of those. These are so adorable. I love it. She made beautiful sequin clusters. I like those as well. I can use them in a flower center or put in a cluster. She's really good at making those. I still have to try those. These are mini tags. Ah, so adorable. Everything that's made tiny is cute, don't you think? I just love all these tiny things. Little tiny postage embellishments. She also used stickers from the Garden Party collection, I see. I do think I made those little embellishments as well with those puffy stickers. Here are some charms she already wire wrapped for me. And here you have some extra sequins that I can use. And here is a normal shaped mini tag. How cute. I really love them. And she decorated the inside as well. Really cute with this beautiful embellishment sticker. So thank you, Nadezhda. Really sweet of you. And I love those tiny embellishments. You know that. I can use them all year long. Then she made a tag flip for me. And this she also, of course, decorated the bags. Really sweet. And this is one of the tag flips that she did. She made several. And on this tag flip, I think it's meant to give me the beautiful bows that she did. Because on every tag that she made is a beautiful handmade bow in a Valentine style. Always really hard to show, I think, those tag flips. But she gifted me a lot of beautiful bows on this. And she decorated the tags really cute as well. So if I take the bows off, I can still use the tags on projects. This one is... Oh, some came off. Well, I will find it in my box. It was a huge box that everything came in, so. Love this tag flip. Now I have a lot of bows as well on hands for my own projects. There is another tag flip that she did. Also in Valentine style. How cute, look. With the Eiffel Tower. This is a puffy sticker that shakes. She used a sticker here. Oh, so cute. Again, bows that I can reuse. Love them. Beautiful colors. Not your typical Valentine colors like this. Love that she combined it with blues and greens. Also really cute. Here we have one. With glitter. Happy Valentine's. Super adorable tag flip again. I have so many beautiful items that I can display in my craft room. I did organize, as you know, some time ago. And yeah, I have some room for the beautiful project that she gave to me. Here she gifted me, and I'm not going to take them out, a lot of these kind of bag toppers that I can decorate myself. And of course she made a beautiful bag topper to go on top. She layered a lot of items up. I do think she got this cookie from me that I made with a die set. A lot of layering, as you can see. She used the Nouveau drops that I got her on. Really sweet. And again, I can use these bag toppers myself. So then we go to the next. Some things that fell out of the packages, but look. I think this is a doodlebug decoration. And this was also really cute. It was on one of the packages. Then we go to the next item. It's again a beautiful album. She made a lot of mini albums for me. Or embellishment albums. I know they take a lot of time. So sweet of her. And this one is made from cardstock. So it's a thin one. It's not a chipboard. It's made from cardstock. She decorated it really cute, as you can see, with the window frame. It doesn't shake, but it has some cute tulle with flowers in the background. I hope you can see it. It says, sweet, all again, Maggie Holmes Garden Party. And on the inside, she put some really cute embellishments that I can use myself. So a layer tag. This is from the garden, the farmer's market. If I am correct, from Maggie Holmes. I still have some papers left as well. So I can combine that with those here also. So cute. I love that collection. I didn't see a lot of people using it. I don't know why. I think it's one of my favorites. The garden party is, but the market collection as well, the farmer's market. Look, here she did decorate the rosettes for me. Love this sticker. You can see through it. Another cute tag. And here she made banners. Can all use them as a card topper, for example, or on a bag topper. So sweet. So that's this one. Now I have another one. Let me take the other one immediately. That's this one. And I am saving these beautiful laces, of course. I don't have a lot of them anymore. So, and this is another cardstock album, as you can see. I think she made it in exactly the same way. And yeah, with different embellishments. How cute is this bike? It's an acetate one. Here, oh, I love this. These can be put on bag toppers so good. Love them. And how cute are these iridescent hearts that she used? Look, beautiful embellishments. This one as well. Tags that I can reuse or hang to a package if I'm giving someone a present. These are mini pockets with an embellished paper clip on the inside. This one as well. Cute to use in planners, for example. So that's this album. She did so much work. It's not normal anymore. Now I'm going to show you one big project. I do think you will recognize it, because I showed it not so long ago in my video. This is the advent box calendar that we did. It was made by her with her Cricut. So she made the base. I just needed to put it all together and decorate. And of course she did the same for me. And she used the Create Paper Collection for it. And on the inside she puts embellishments. Some that I can take out so I can reuse it like this. This is also a cookie I gifted her, if I am correct. But there are also some drawers with decorations on the inside that stays in there so that she glued together. Look, some ephemera pieces. I will go through them quickly because there are a lot of drawers. This one is sweet as well, as you can see. Also a beautiful tag. She did so much Valentine crafting this year. Wow. Here she made a shaker bottom. It cannot go out. But I can use it on my desk with embellishments. Again, some beautiful tassels. And she made some charms, some hoop charms for me. Love those as well. To hang to any project. So cute. And here we have the next drawer. With some die cuts that I can use, saying love. We go to the other side. It's decorated with hugs and kisses. And do you believe it's Look, this one is glued in, so it cannot be taken out. And do you believe how much work this was to make? You need to decorate every panel with paper, glue anything, everything together. It was such a large project. I had my husband helping with putting the tape on the pieces of the drawers before I glued them together. So I had some help because it was so much work. It was the largest project we agreed on. Look, here she included some shaker pieces and some nice bows. And here we have another embellishment that stays inside. It's just a beautiful scene that she made. Here is a cute little cupcake. Gorgeous foam flowers that I can use myself. Love those. I've already ran out of them, so I'm happy to find them. This is another little layout she did in the drawer. How cute. She made it just like a tiny house or something. Oh, some of the shaker hearts. I don't have any of those, so I'm really happy with those. You can also make them into charms. If I add a hole and an eyelet, I can hang it to a charm as well. Or as a charm. So cute. And then we go to the last side, I think. Yeah, she made it as the whole drawer as a shaker. You see how cute. Gorgeous mix that she used as well. Here are some, well, I do think these are candy hearts that I can eat. So, another nice snack for my craft room. And here she also included this that stays in. Here another cupcake. It's really hard to show you these projects. So big. Look, cute little shaker mix for Valentine's Day. I will keep it for next year. And a cute little scene as well with the house from the garden party. She used a chocolate bar flatback. So, so cute. Thank you, Nadezhda. I really love it. And I'm going to display it in my craft room, of course. And then she gifted me these. She made this herself. Do you see how much work goes into these flowers? It's not normal. So many details. She put it on a baking paper or how do you call that? So I can easily take it off. And I am for sure going to use them. I will put the big box a little bit away because it takes away from my lighting, I think. Yeah, now it's better. Then, here is a nice paper bag that she decorated. And on the inside is another tag flip. And this is a tag flip I think we did agree on. A spring tag flip. So, really sweet. She used craft cardstock for the base of the tags of this one. And she embellished it really, really beautiful. Oh, I must be in frame. And in the back she made pockets and she included flowers and mini tags for me. Do you see how many layers are on this one? Can you see it? A frame, chipboard, lace, a flourish, a tag sticker, sequins. She used tiny, tiny dots of Nouveau drops on this die cut. Wow. Nadezhda. Look, and here is an envelope. She added a cute, beautiful charm to it. And on the inside are some ephemera pieces that I can use with my digital papers from Crate. This is also really gorgeous. Another pocket with a gorgeous little tag with a nice little bow charm. Wow. So many details. And I love the papers that she used for this. I have to ask her which collection this was. I really like it. Some chipboard hearts in gold that she heat embossed. And look, beautiful flower charm. Here is another spring sequin mix for me that I can use in shakers. I've done so many videos today, so I hear that my voice is a little bit changing because I talked too much. Here are again flowers and look, this cute strawberry. I love it. It's so cute. I don't have anything like that. Gorgeous big flower here and on the back another cute envelope pocket with a cute charm and some stickers. So, This was the third, did you count? This is the third tag flip that was in my box. Not normal. Then we have here the beautiful Valentine pocket. Let's see what she put in there. This one I did not take out yet, so I didn't see it. Again, nice clustering on the baggies. And here is a Valentine pocket that she did using a die, I do think, from AliExpress. But I think she used a border punch on top to cut out these daisies. So sweet. Happy Valentine Day, love. And on the inside she has some. Some hard embellishments that I can take off. I think it's a sticker, so I have to peel it off. That she cut out for me. A big embellishment. That's the same. And here is a memory dex card. Oh yeah, we also did a memory dex card for Valentine's Day last year. Look how cute she used the lipstick. Big hearts. A lot of layering. So many layers, as you can see. So thank you, Nadezhda. Nice pocket. Already running out of space on my desk. Then, what's this? This looks like a notebook or something. Life is sweet. Let's take it out. What do we have here? Gorgeous applique. Oh, look how clever she did put the tulle bow through the holes of the applique. That's a cute idea. And when we open it, oh, I have it the wrong way up. Look how cute. Goes like a gatefold. And then you have a book here. How cute, you use the binding rings. Love it. It says discover. A lot of texture. Oh, I am out of frame. A lot of texture. Can you see it? She used tulle here with the snow, faux snow. Perfect day. Ah, really cute. You fill my heart with sunshine. Remember this. Oh, this is an envelope. I don't know if there's something in it. Probably is. Ah, a cute journaling card. This is a shaker. Another shaker with tulle. Can you see it? How cute. And a beautiful umbrella filled with the gorgeous flowers. I hope I can take this off. I am wanting to reuse this. I really love these embellishments. Those layered flowers that she does, they are just perfect. And look, ooh, what's this? This is some kind of a sticker. It's gorgeous. Wow. So another kind of mini album. It's not normal how many albums and flips she made for me. It takes so much time. I know it's so time consuming to make those things. Let's look. Oh, some of the hoop charms came out, and it's just the cutest one with the swan. Can you see it? I love this. It probably hang from something. What do we still have? I've got two things left. This is the first one. Another book box. Also a Valentine theme. Look how cute. How many flowers she used here to frame this cute little image. Nouveau drops. Ah, this is so cute. Love these flower clusters. It's adorable. Beautiful paper. And this is again like a box. So let's look what's on the inside. Oh, some flowers for me to use. Look how cute are these papers. Gorgeous. Tiny flowers with pearls on the inside that I can use myself. Wow. And again, gorgeous. I will take them out. Gorgeous handmade embellishments that I can reuse. Oh, there are some stickers that look like faux wax seals. Love those. Love to make them, but sometimes to have a sticker on hand that's already done, it's also really nice. Here is a cute Valentine back topper that I can reuse. And look, these are embellished rosette that she made from crepe paper. And with cute strawberries. Ah, so adorable. Aren't those sweet? Thank you, Nadezhda. I have a lot of embellishments on hand now that I can reuse. Or just take if I am crafting. And then we go to the last project. And that's also a big one. And maybe you recognize that I make it myself as well. We decided on doing journals for each other. And we used the Let's Get Crafty collection from one of our favorite brands, Simple Stories. My journal was with, and I will link it below, it was really cute. I made it with several mixed media techniques, so I had so much fun creating that journal for her. And yeah, this is the one that she made for me. And what I love is that she put an acetate shaker. Don't you just love the sound of this? In front of the journal, I love it. She used tulle on top. She did, just like I did, reinforce every page and use bookbinding rings, because then you can easily take everything out and write on it. Because I am planning to use this as a crafty idea journal, because yeah, it's the Let's Get Crafty collection. It's just too cute not to use for crafting things. So yeah, I don't know if this is, yeah, this is just an embellishment, I think. Oh no, it is open on the side, so I can put something in it. And she did use beautiful things to embellish this page with. Love those. I love me some bling. And on the side, she used a cute little green pompon trim. Then we go to the back page. She made a large bucket. Oh, I want to craft with somebody. I want to make cute things with somebody. That's from a Whitney Houston song. Oh, I want to dance with somebody. But then craft-wise. Huh? Cute. This is a decorated journaling card from the collection. We both have this collection. Oh, I love this one. Beautiful. We both have the Let's Get Crafty collection digital. And then you can print everything out on the scale that you want. So you are not limited to one size. Here she made an acetate envelope, some extra journaling cards, I will leave them in, and she added some beautiful page tabs and stickers for me to use. So cute. Then we go to this page. This is a tuck spot. I can put something in there, and there as well. Chipboard, die cuts. She also combined a lot of materials. Here is a flip that she made with the cards, ideas, so I can jot down crafting ideas, currently crafting. So cute. Here is another tuck spot, a large one, with the tags that she printed out really big. And she made them extra sturdy, put them on a craft base, on a card base. And it says create here on the tab. This stays like this. Cute little page. I can put something between there with the paper clip. Here she used a part of a pocket letter pocket. Can you see it? And added some extra ephemeras for me to use. I still have a lot of things left for the Let's Get Crafty collection and the paper digital, so I can make a lot of projects with it. I have one project in mind that I want to make for Mother's Day, and I am so hoping that I can find the time to do that for her. It's a 3D project. And it's on my list for a long time. And I could not make it for her birthday. So I hope I can make it in time for my mother's... for Mother Day, for my mother. Free time equals craft time. Yes, that's so true for me. If I'm free, I'm going to do Zumba. Or I am going to craft. Look how cute. Well, and I also like to watch movies with my husband on Netflix. And we do a lot of board games as well. Well, I do think it's not only crafting and Zumba that I do when I am off. We do like to play cards with friends and board games with friends as well from time to time. This is a nice flip that she made with the text. Put them all together besides and then cut it out. I did that as well, I think. That are the things that you can do when you have your paper digital. So you can put them all together, digitally print them out, then cut and make the fold lines. And then you have a flip book like this. And I love that she did some of the printing on craft cardstock. The colors came out so different then. Really beautiful. I love that. Beautiful floral paper. All the crafty things. It's another flip that I can use. Currently crafting. A tuck spot from the embroidery hoop. So adorable. And she cut out some jars for me. Oh, this is also... Oh, wait a minute. Did I miss that? Oh no, it's not on everyone. Well, I did miss some of them. Look. These are journaling cards that she put on the inside. Oh, how could I miss it? Every time you take a look at such a project, then you see different things that you missed. Because there are so many details in this one. Look, they are really large cards. And she also made them... No. Not as a pocket. How cute are those? I do think I did that myself as well. Well, I put it back after the video. Oh no, I was at the wrong spot. Yes, she used another cute pompon trim, but then a white one. So it's a smaller one than a green one. Look how cute. This is also one of my favorite pages with the items with the words, also really cute. Another beautiful craft page. Here she added some ephemera as well as another pocket with ephemera. Then we go to this page. This is a flip up, flip down. I don't know how it's called exactly, but for me it's a flip up and down. And she put some tags on the side for me to use. And then we go, yeah, this was the last page. So we go to the back of the journal. And that concludes this cute little craft journal. And I just love it. Well, we are at 32 minutes now. I didn't think I could show you everything in one video. But I guess I could. So I'm very curious what you think about this swap from Nadezhda. Nadezhda, again, thank you so very much for doing this swap for me and crafting so many items. I really love what you did, but you know I love your crafting. Eh? We know each other for several years now, and yeah, we just really know from each other what we like and what we can make for each other. So thank you so much. I hope you will take a look at the channel of Nadezhda. I will put the link to her channel, of course, in the description box below. And I hope you will be back for my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.